Conversational exploratory essay writing, or synthesis essay writing, takes an idea, then after researching the initial idea and its antithesis, comes up with a synthesized idea that bridges the gap between the two points of view. After rejecting weak points in the antithesis, the synthesized argument comes up with a new thesis that is based on the strengths of the antithesis and its overlap with the initial thesis. Usually, this is some kind of qualified thesis where the premises and definitions and facts will need to be discussed for the argument to maintain clarity and persuasiveness. A synthesis essay takes two opposing views and comes up with a third view that synthesizes the best of both worlds. An example of synthesis in the physical world is the joining of a sperm and an egg. They're completely different, yet their union results in a new organism. You will need at least 8 paragraphs in your essay. They will be 1, a hook story or example, 2, a thesis-antithesis exploration paragraph, 3, a context paragraph. The 4 through 6 paragraphs each include a claim, evidence, and reasoning, and they could be as diverse as a logical argument, a quote from an expert, or an appeal to the reader's conscience. 7th paragraph is a synthesized new thesis paragraph, and finally the 8th paragraph is a punchline or conclusion to your hook story or example paragraph. Before writing the essay, you must do these research activities. 1. Read the prompt. 2. Brainstorm for a hook story. 3. Annotate the texts for thesis and antithesis points. 4. Come up with a synthesis idea and the best supporting points for this. 5. Decide on a hook story that will also have a good punchline that agrees with your synthesis idea. Each type of paragraph can be split into 2 or more paragraphs if your ideas are more complex than 1 paragraph allows. Remember that 7 paragraphs will be about 2 pages, and you'll have time to write up to maybe 4 pages during the exam. The exam readers often give higher scores to more complex essays, and those will also tend to be longer. You will start your essay with a story or example that is related to the topic in the prompt. After reading the prompt, jot down a few words to remind you of possible stories or examples to tell. These can be from your own life or from current events, history, literature, film, or other writing you have found on the topic. Let the analysis of your story have a question in it here at the beginning of the paper. That way, the research helps you find a conclusion analysis for your story. After researching the texts and coming up with a synthesized thesis, come back to your story possibilities and choose one whose conclusion exemplifies your thesis, I mean your synthesis. You may pause this movie with the space bar and then click the Read the Prompt link, and that will take you to a web page that has the whole prompt, the question, and all the texts for you to read. So read those prompts and annotate the texts, marking the strong and weak claims. The goal of research is to close the gaps between opposing viewpoints, to provide ideas that help both parties come to a new place of policy and understanding that takes into account the strengths of both views. You may pause this slide by pressing the space bar if you want to go to some websites that explain and give definitions for some of these terms. There is a link on the word dialectic, also on both arrows below, see dialectic logic and what is good research. There are great web pages with articles on this topic. So the second paragraph in your essay will state a preliminary thesis, perhaps in the form of a rhetorical question, or else as an hypothesis using possibility words such as perhaps, ideally, often we think, it seems that. Then you state the antithesis, discussing its weak and strong points. At this point, you don't state your thesis yet, though. You've come to understand what that synthesis might be due to the research you already did, but first you will discuss the strong claims that support your concluding synthesis. This is what is exploratory about your essay. You are bringing the reader along on a journey that explores the new ideas that your synthesis has come up with. After you have joined the human conversation on your essay topic by acknowledging the strengths and weaknesses of the antithesis, addressing the gap between the thesis and antithesis, and coming up with a synthesis statement in your notes, now it's time to list the premises, definitions, and facts that undergird the synthesis idea. This context paragraph will then discuss these premises, definitions, and facts. This allows the reader to start the argument on the same page with you. Up until now, you have drawn in the reader with the story or example that brings meaning to the topic in the hook paragraph. You have then framed the question by showing the thesis and antithesis in the second dialectic paragraph. Then you have shown the foundation for your synthesis conclusion by discussing premises, definitions, and facts. You have then developed a synthesis that results in a new thesis, but you haven't stated this yet to your reader. First, you will discuss the claims that came up in your research that support your synthesized thesis. You might have all three kinds of claims on this slide, or you may use only one kind and then use the other two kinds of argumentation when you provide reasoning for your claims. So the body of your paragraph will have three paragraphs, at least, with three different claims. They are the points that support your new synthesized thesis. Each of these paragraphs that has a claim also has evidence and then reasoning or argument that explains it. The evidence will be integrated into the middle of your supporting point paragraphs. You may use any or all of the kinds of evidence listed here. Be sure to use only the strongest examples as evidence. After you have stated a claim and revealed the evidence, discuss the connections between the claim, evidence, and your synthesized thesis. This may feel redundant, but you're merely allowing the reader to understand the thought processes you went through when you noticed how the thesis and antithesis worked out to a new synthesis idea. By taking your reader through your own thought processes, you will persuade your reader to your point of view if your synthesis idea is well thought out. Second to last paragraph of your essay will state the new thesis that you have made by synthesizing your research and the previous thesis and antithesis. It will also summarize the argument that led you to this place in new words. Don't just repeat what you've already said. The final paragraph will tell the rest of the story or example that you started with at the beginning of the essay, and it shows how the new synthesized thesis works out in this story.